Good morning everyone. Today we are talking about the sheet of electrical. This sheet will be firstly divided into two parts. One will be at the site level and another is at the building end, as you have already been told in the class. So firstly we will talk about the site level. At site level, two things are needed to be done. First of all, we need to have the calculations of electrical loads in summers or in winters. You can calculate anyone. I'll prefer if you calculate in summers because the electrical load is more, and this basically calculation is done to know what power of a generator we need in our house, if it is needed or if it is not needed. So I'll prefer if you do it for the summer, so because the electrical load in the summer is more. So firstly, and then at the site level, you need to place give a specific place for your generators and electric substations if the project is very large. Like if you are doing for the malls, if you are doing for the motels, you can place it, but if you are doing for the residential buildings, it is not at all needed. Then at the building level, you have to talk about the placement of electrical appliances, connection with the switches, legend should be very much proper, and the diameter. Firstly, we will talk in detail about the calculation of electrical loads. So this is the type of table we made for the calculation. So for the first very column, which we make is of serial number, and then the items which you have placed, the appliances which you are going to place in your room that are needed to be added, like bulbs, switchboard, bulbs, ACs, ceiling fans, everything need to be added one by one. Then their quantity, their numbers you need to be added. Like if you have two lights in your room, then the number needs to be added here so that we can multiply it with the votes, and then the number of volts it is using, that needs to be added. With this, when we will multiply this quantity with the volts, we'll get our power. Then the number of hours, this is approximate, which we have to add. Approximately, you have to tell that in your house or in your building, how many hours we are going to use that particular appliance. After that, we need to tell how many days in a week that particular appliance will be used. Like if we talk about our houses only, then if we know that in our house we use that particular appliance for if all the week, whole of the week, then you can add the seven days in a week, or whatever the number of days it is. According to commercial buildings, if there is a holiday on Sunday, then you will add the 6 days in a week. According to that, you have to add the number of days. With that, you have to calculate the total amount of energy use, and average daily amount of energy use in the day by multiplying these. Then we will have a total power for the whole room. This whole will be calculated for one room. If you have a number of rooms which are different from one another, then you have to calculate these calculations for all. You will calculate the kilowatts used by the whole of your building. First of all, if you have same type of rooms in your house, then you can calculate it once for one room and then multiply it with your number of same rooms as you have in the case of motels. But if you are doing this for the residential buildings, then please calculate for the whole your house at once only. Add the number of quantities according to your whole house rather than doing it for whole room. So the changes can be according to your project. Now after the calculations comes the part, then what are the various appliances that you need to add in your houses. So the major appliances, I am telling you a list of the major appliances that needed to be placed in a room. In addition of these appliances, you can add whatever appliances you want. So a telephone point, switchboard, ceiling fan, plug points both of 5 amperes and 15 amperes. 15 amperes is the power switch that needs to be there. And please take care of the heights which you are taking for it. In your lecture notes uploaded on UMS, the heights of all these are mentioned and their symbols is also mentioned, which are used for in the MBC. So please refer them before making the sheets. Then add the TV points, exhaust fans, bell points if they are needed. In the case of motels, the bell points will be needed. Otherwise, in the residential buildings, there will be only one bell point at the entrance. Then split ACs, tube lights, bell push or buzzers wherever it is needed. Then the cameras and the CCTV cameras they are needed in the case of in motels, they will be needed in the corridors, and in case of your residential buildings, you can add them at the entrance, or you can give them at if you want, you can give them in your lobby as well. Then that at the building level, you need to tell the placement of your meter boards, your distribution boards, your inverter points, and whatever the appliances you are adding in your drawing rooms, kitchen, chimney points, they needed to be added according to your project.